friends, Brooke here from BrookeAlexandra.tv, and today we're going to be making a Thai red curry lentil dish. What I love about this recipe is that it's so simple. I had a friend's going away party last week, and I made this, was able to throw everything on the stove, go finish getting ready for the guests, and everyone was so pleased. Thai is one of my favorite foods, and it used to be pretty intimidating making everything from scratch. So you can get a Thai red curry paste at the grocery store, and that's what I'm gonna be using today, so you too can try this at home. Today we're gonna be using some black foods. Now, black foods are high in the antioxidant anthocyanin. Anthocyanin is great for protecting us from free radicals. It helps with our memory improvement, as well as decreasing our risk of heart attack and cancer. So we're using a japonica rice, which is a black rice, also called forbidden rice, as well as beluga lentils. We'll start with the beluga lentils and get our pan going here. And we're gonna wanna boil them first, so you can put it up to a pretty high heat. I have one can of coconut milk, the rest water to equal 2 cups. And we're gonna add our beluga lentils and bring that to a simmer. And then we're gonna drop it down to low. Next, we're gonna start the japonica rice. So it's 2 cups water to 1 cup rice. Again, heat on high, because we're gonna bring it to a simmer. And our 2 cups of this gorgeous black rice. This is one of my favorite rice. I think it is my favorite rice. It turns kind of purple when it's done cooking, and it's just really, really beautiful. Now we have both our belugas and our rice boiling, so we're gonna drop those both down to a simmer and cover them up. Next, we're gonna start with the vegetables. I have a beautiful yellow bell pepper and an orange one, and we'll get started with those. We're gonna cut them into slices. Now we're gonna chop the onions. I have 2 small yellow onions because I found them at the farmer's market and they were adorable, but 1 medium yellow onion would work just fine. Next, we're gonna chop up 2 cloves of garlic. Because we want our beluga lentils nice and creamy for that curry, I got some warm water. I'm gonna add the red curry. It's 1 tablespoon plus 1 teaspoon of red curry paste, and then 1 teaspoon of salt. Mix that up. We're gonna put it into our lentils. So now that we've got that stirred in really well, go ahead and cover up the lentils and cook for another 15 minutes. I love to save time and steps and clean up, so I have figured out a great way to steam your vegetables on top of the rice. We're gonna add all the vegetables on top of our black rice for the last 15 minutes of cooking. Now we'll cover them back up and make sure they're at a nice . The lentils cooked for about 35 minutes, and I turned them off and just let them sit and continue steaming. And then this japonica rice takes about 50 minutes. So the vegetables are done steaming on top, so I'm just gonna take them off because we're gonna add some flavorings to our rice. The forbidden rice is ready, and we're gonna add 1 tablespoon of coconut oil and one of my absolute favorite ingredients that you guys will see me using a lot. This is ume plum vinegar. It adds a lot of flavor. It's salty and tangy and delicious. So when you use it, you also don't need to use salt. So I will be adding, and it's got this little top on it, so it's really just sprinkling. You don't want to use a lot or you can overpower your food. So for this whole pan, I'm probably using about 3/4 of a teaspoon. Now, I'm gonna show you a little trick that's super fun, and you use a ramekin. Kind of makes a little mold, so you wanna press it in there. And then you take your plate and put it upside down, and then flip it, and you should have a nice, pretty little pile on your plate. Now we're gonna add some of these gorgeous red curry beluga lentils. And now we're gonna top it off with our garlic, onion, and bell pepper. All right, friends, now for my favorite part. It is time to taste test. a super delicious dish. The japonica rice adds a nutty, super hearty flavor. And on top, the beluga lentils and that coconut red curry is super creamy and just delightful. Thank you so much for joining me. If you like this, like the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel and head on over to brookealexandra.tv for this recipe and so much more sauciness on the blog. Signing off with so much love and gratitude. Ciao for now.